Pat to Paul from the locker room. If you haven't already, please make sure to subscribe. Trying to reach 1,500 subscribers for the end of January. Let's get into it. Bo Horvat has been rumored to go to the Boston Bruins. Now, there's been a few teams that have been in this sweepstakes. I just want to discuss the Bruins, and I will probably talk about the Maple Leafs in a day or two and kind of break that down. Bo Horvat has done really well this year. In 29 games played, he has 21 goals, 9 assists for 30 points. He's over a point per game pace and a 0 plus minus, so he's kind of neutral out there defensively. But Vancouver's team defensively isn't amazing, so I'm not going to just blame him for that. The reason why Horvat is even being discussed of being traded is his contract is up at the end of the year. $5.5 million, that's something people can eat, and even if Vancouver can eat some of that cap hit, Vancouver is looking like, well, Horvat most likely won't re-sign here, so let's try to get some return on our investment. Why I don't think it makes sense for the Bruins is that they would have to sell the future to make this deal make sense for the Canucks, giving up prospects like Lysell, maybe some draft picks. And do the Bruins really want to do that? Are they in the position to start giving up young, good players that could contribute next season or the season after that? Cap-wise, they have nothing available this year. They have $39,000 available, so obviously they can't afford an NHL contract. Some of the counter arguments would be that Bergeron, Krejci, Smith, Foligno would all get off the books next year, including Nosek as well, which would give you about $12.1 million in cap space. The problem with that, David Pastrnak is due for a contract. And also, those players subtracted from the cap hit, you also need to fill out the rest of your roster. Bo Horvat, in premise, makes a lot of good sense because the Bruins need to get a really good first-line center. Can Pavel Zacha fill that void as the second-line center? I think so. I think he's done an admirable job when Krejci's been out of the lineup. I don't think he's a first-line center. But Horvat probably could fill that role pretty well. Pastrnak is probably going to get around the $10 million range just because of the current rate. He is an elite-level goal scorer or elite-level point producer, so I don't blame a player trying to get that money when he can. With about $12.15 million and then obviously $6.6 come off the book, so to re-sign Pastrnak and then add four more players to fill those voids, $18.75 isn't that much. And are you going to allocate all of your cap hit towards Pastrnak and Horvat? Because if that is the case, you're just going to be looking at using entry-level contracts to help you get by the next few years. I'm not completely sold this is going to be Bergeron's last season. He's discussed that he thinks about it every year now. It's kind of a year-by-year process, but he's still playing at a very good level. I think Krejci has looked exceptionally well. 8 goals, 13 assists for 21 points in 24 games played. He does not look like he's lost a step. If anything, I think the year off has benefited him because he just looks rejuvenated. He still looks like old David Krejci. And I also think just from a prospect pool, the Bruins aren't extremely deep with prospects. I think you need to keep the good ones you have because you need those players to start coming up in the system and kind of contributing at the NHL level. I would rather just keep Lysell. Maybe he doesn't pan out to be being a top line guy, but he could finish as a middle six guy, and on a cheap contract, that is something you need. I like Bo Horvat. I like a lot of things about his game. I think he can be really good. I think he would be an amazing fit for the Bruins, but I just think cap hit wise and the price we would have to pay, it doesn't make much sense. Now, if he's available and he's willing to take a reasonable contract to come to Boston, that'd be great. I just don't see that happening because I think most players are going to get the money when they can. But when you're in an organization like the Canucks that have struggled to win, maybe he does take a little bit of a cheaper discount so he can be on a contender. But as of right now, I just don't really see a trade working out for the Bruins and the Canucks where Horvat wears a spoke to be. Let me know your thoughts down below. Do you think the Bruins should acquire Horvat? Or do you think giving up futures like Lysell would be too much of a price to pay? I'm Kat DePaul for the Locker Room, and I'll see you in the next video.